All right, good. Check the generator.
Yes, master.
Life! Life, do you hear me? Give my creation life!
Our video yesterday, just jump on our YouTube channel and you'll be able to see it there.
That's great, Mr. Zygmunt.
One thing I love about Science Week is it really encourages young people to try to come up with different ideas to fix things that are going on in the world. Sometimes people that have been inventing things for a long time don't actually have that fresh perspective that young people do, and that's why it's so important that people like you watching have a think about how you can fix things in the world.
Tell us more, Mr. Zygmunt.
Guys, have a look at the next clip that I'm about to show you. See how this young inventor has been able to fix our oceans and make them a better place for everyone.
If you close your eyes and squint a bit, you could pretend this 600 metre long tube is some kind of giant ocean snake. It's not, though. It's a device with a very special mission to catch the ocean's rubbish, or at least some of it. It's being towed out to a part of the Pacific Ocean known as the Great Garbage Patch. The water currents here happen to make lots of plastic rubbish drift together, and I mean lots, an area almost the size of Queensland. Until now, it's been too difficult, too big, and too expensive to do much about it. That was until this guy came along, Boyan Slat. This snake thing was his idea, and it all started when he was still at school.
I realised, back in high school, there might be an alternative.
For a school project, he designed a system of floating barriers that would be up to 100 kilometres long. They'd sit in the path of ocean currents in a V-shape to capture and funnel any floating plastic. Then these giant towers would suck it all up.
Instead of going after the plastics, you could simply wait for the plastic to come to you.
We've spent a lot of time telling you about plastic pollution on BTN.
Yep, a recent study found that Aussies discard more than 9 billion pieces of plastic every year. Unlike paper or cardboard, plastic takes a really, really long time to break down.
I've come to realise that our precious marine life are getting killed by the so-called innocent plastic bag.
But finding solutions hasn't been easy, and with so much plastic already in our oceans killing our marine life, Boyan and his organisation, Ocean Cleanup, are hopeful they can tackle the problem one giant snake at a time.
I mean, this is pretty incredible. I mean, something that we've been working towards for 5 years, and just having it seen from the early conceptual sketches to, you know, now the first unit actually going through the Golden Gate and heading to the garbage patch is pretty incredible.
It's aiming to trap some of the 1.8 trillion pieces of plastic that scientists estimate are swirling around here, while still letting marine life safely swim beneath it. It's fitted with solar-powered lights, cameras, sensors, and satellite antennas. And the design will make it easy for boats to fish out the collected plastic every few months and transport it to dry land where it will be recycled. Boyan is now 24, and despite the years of work that have gone into this, he says the system will still get some more tweaks in the coming months. The hope is to take it even further by letting 60 of these giant snakes loose on the Pacific Ocean by 2020. That's a lot of hungry snakes who surely won't be going hungry. But hopefully they do at some point.
Wow, that was pretty good, wasn't it? So it just goes to show that if you have a good idea and you, you know, follow it through, it can actually be quite successful.
What are we doing today, Mr. Zygmunt?
Now, today what we're going to do is we're going to come up with our own ideas. So I've attached a link into the video. If you follow that link, you'll be able to play a game called The Incredible Machine on your browser, and that will let you come up with your own crazy inventions. So have a look and come up with some ideas with your families, and also take some screenshots if you'd like and email them to me. I'd love to see them, and I might be able to put some of those in the yearbook. That just takes me right back there, that does. Oh. If you don't have access to a device to play that game, why not just create something in real life and take photos and send them to me? I'd love to be able to see what kinds of things you guys can come up with at home. Don't forget that on Friday, we are going to be showcasing our inner scientists. So don't forget to go online, pick a scientist that you really want to dress up as. And on Friday, when we do our WebExes, I'd love to see lots of you wearing crazy scientist outfits. Well, not crazy scientist outfits, but crazy outfits, I should say, of not so crazy scientists.
That's great, Mr. Zygmunt.
If you're interested in learning more about Deep Blue or about National Science Week, just go to their websites. Just Google Deep Blue or Google National Science Week and you'll find out everything you need to.